Hey guys, Melanie here. So I'm gonna be telling you my life story, how I grew up, how I lost my dad, how I lost my dog Cece. I don't know if you can hear me, or if you can, great. But I don't know if you can hear my sister's music because she's just across the hall from me, from my room. So, as I was saying earlier, I'm gonna be talking about my life. I had a few minutes to pause the video because my sister's door was open, and I don't know if you guys could hear me on that point. So that's why I paused the video. So I'm gonna be sharing you my life, and I don't know how long it's gonna be. How the story is gonna be, so don't mind me if it's an hour long or if it's 30 minutes long. If it's 30 minutes long, great. If it's an hour long, fantastic. So, okay, I'm gonna start it off the day I was born. So, my birthday is on March 5th, 1998. At 7:45 p.m. on a Thursday night. It was a sunset, so it was like around sunset when that happened. I had a stroke. Like, as you can see my hand, it's not like how this hand is, but I had a stroke when my mom was only 7 months pregnant, when I was inside of her. Like, inside her womb. By the time I was, like, a week after I was born, I had to go to Sick Kids Hospital. I had to stay in Toronto for a week. Just to see if I could, like, know. Breathe. I was, like, in this, glass box where the mother could, like, not touch the baby with the two holes. I think you know what I'm saying if you look it up. Like, I think it's, like, you know, for babies, like, you know, who have disabilities or they can't breathe, like, their lungs not developed. For normal babies, they don't get the box, but they get that small little bed, which normal kids get. When I was, like, basically 1 year old, I had no clue whatsoever what I was doing. I was, like, looking around as usual, like how babies are. By the age of two years old, I started to, like, not remember things. I remember when my dad actually let me hold a smoke, because he smokes. Some dad smokes. My dad was way worse. Right now, he's gone. He's up in heaven. If you hear me, Dad, rest in peace. So basically, he's been doing, like, no smoking before I was born. When I was, like, you know, in my mom's stomach, when my mom was only 7 months pregnant. That was in January, January 1998, so basically. My dad, was a pretty interesting man. He's just, like, you know, you don't want to piss him off, because if he was still alive right now and you pissed my dad off, you're gonna end up in a hospital, I'm just saying. But since he's not around on Earth, it's just kind of like, now I have a free life, but, like, still, I have, like, one older sister and one mother now. So by the age of two, my dad let me hold a smoke. It wasn't lit or anything. It was just, like, where you get it out of the package. he let me hold a smoke, and what happened is that I put it inside my mouth because I saw my dad doing that, but it wasn't lit, so that was not too bad. It wasn't lit, I didn't start smoking, and I never will start smoking ever. Hey, phone's ringing. Sorry about that. By the age of 3, like, nothing new really happened. Age of 2, I started going to Portugal and all that kind of stuff. Because I'm Portuguese, I'm half Portuguese. I could see, as you could see, the flag right here. So, yeah. By the age of 3, I started talking. But here's the thing. All normal kids, they all say, like, no. Why or no or any kind of like normal where it's like no swearing, knock and stuff. But for me it was kind of different because I heard my dad keep on swearing a lot, and my first words was vai pra pura, which means go F yourself. And I was just like this. You know what, daddy? Go, vai pra pura. And then he was like this. So you know how to swear, but you never learned how to talk? And that was when I was like, you know, I was like, no, the bad girl in school. Like, this is like, you know, before kindergarten when I started to swear. Before kindergarten, before I even went to school. And, what it is that, like, now, I kept on swearing a lot in school. I kept on getting in trouble every single day. I kept on, getting in trouble, and all that stuff. And I've been doing it since the end of grade 5, but when I was in grade 5, I did way, way worse. So yeah, but like when I was 6 years old, that's where like I crossed the limit of getting myself in trouble. So yeah, passing grade, I don't know, like five, passing 4 and 5, because nothing new really happened. So in that time, like, I was just ordinary, I was just going to school, my parents sent me off to school, and all that kind of stuff. What it is that when I was in grade one, my teacher, I'm not gonna say her name, but I know it's a she, because she was my grade one teacher, and if she's actually watching this now in the future, you didn't take care of me properly. You didn't take me properly. My mom would have wanted to kill you at that time. So when I was 6 years old, and this is what I told you a few seconds before, a few minutes ago, that I crossed the line of getting myself in trouble. So what happened is that my teacher sent me out in the hallways, like in front of the school, because she told me that my mom was picking me up. But here's the thing, if I was a teacher at that school, Our Lady of Fatima, which is my elementary school, I don't go any there anymore. So yeah, because I went to 2 elementary schools. One, Our Lady of Fatima, was when I was like in kindergarten to grade 4, and then between grade 4, that's when my dad passed away and all that stuff. So it was just kind of hard for me at that period of time. And yeah, so going back when I was 6, what happened is that my mom was going to pick me up to go for a doctor's appointment. And this doctor, I liked him since I was a baby. And I could only had him, like, I only had him as an orthodontist. No, orthodontist. A pediatrician. For 18 years. And since that's up, because I'm already 19. I had him since I was a baby. So he was a really nice doctor. He was, like, what my number one favorite doctor. So if he's actually watching this, hi, I'm on YouTube. I'm not gonna say his name or else I'm gonna expose him or something. Not expose, but like say his name out loud to the world. And he was a really awesome doctor. So going back to when I was six, so I ran away from school. Like, I was like waiting like 15 minutes straight on the front waiting for my mom. And what happened is that for me, like, for kids that are really impatient, they tend to like know when are our parents are gonna come, when are they coming. So basically I ran off from school. I ran away from school. And I was like 2 kilometers away from the school, and the school had to call the police to hunt me down and bring me back to school because I wanted to go home. I knew the pathway to go home at that time, so it was just kind of like I knew where I was going. What else? So the police came, they brought me back to school. And this teacher, that my grade one teacher, the one that sent me out in the front, and I was an impatient person, so it was just kind of like, it was hard for me to like not wait any longer. And trust me, I still do that to this day. Like, I can't wait any longer. There had to be a that period kind of time. Okay, I'm gonna say it like that, where I'm waiting. And what it is that I can't wait as long. If that person says, oh, I'm gonna be in that store for like maybe 15 minutes. I'll wait 15 minutes, and if they don't like now stop, like if they're still in that store, I'm just like, can we go? And what happens is that like both my mom and my dad, because my dad was still around on Earth at that time, he came in a green truck. That green truck is no longer in my driveway right now. So yeah. So what was I gonna say? Like, but my mom got pissed off at my teacher, and yes, I still swear. I still curse, and I don't give two fucks about it. If people are like, this girl swears. So yeah. So my mom got mad. The teacher almost got herself fired or fired. My mom can describe the time or describe her mind. She can't make up her mind. It's like that What Do You Mean song from Justin Bieber. So yeah. During that time, my mom got mad at my grade one teacher. And I was like not a bad person. I'm no longer a bad person, ever. No. I'm no longer. I stopped being bad at the age of grade 5. Oh. At the age of 10, when I was in grade 5. So, by the age of, skipping through grade 2, yeah, skipping through grade 2, because nothing really happened in grade 2, I still kept getting in trouble a lot, so, yeah, I explained that. Grade 3, I had a favorite teacher at that time. Now I have another favorite teacher. I think my grade 3 teacher, I think she's retired. Because after 10 years, she looked like she was in her 20s. Maybe right now she's in her 40s or 50s. So maybe she's like at the time where she's retiring. Not good stuff. I gotta see her someday, but I can't. I don't know where she lives. At that time, I had a favorite soccer player, and that soccer player is Cristiano Ronaldo. I used to play soccer a lot when I was in grade 3. Trust me. I still have my, jersey that I took the picture in that photo over there. It's right over there, but yeah. So, during that, like, no, she was kind of like my favorite teacher that I experienced to do soccer. I got an A in gym in grade 8, so that's a good sign. When I was in grade 4, I still kept on getting in trouble. Like, I started to kick people. I was a very bad person. And it was a habit of mine. And I ended it in grade 5. I just ended it in grade 5. So, when I was in grade 4, I kept on getting in trouble and all that stuff. I had to switch schools because I was being bullied because of how I'm handicapped. And yes, like, as I showed you earlier, that I had a stroke. It happens. Like, even my uncle, he had a stroke as well. So, between grade 4 to grade 5, I had to be switched schools. So, the school that I used to go to is, like, right down there. Like, right behind, I'm not right behind the elementary school, but, like, it'll take me, like, 15 minutes just to get to the school. So, that's just kind of the thing. And what it is that, like, no, I had a rough period of time in that year. And this was, like, in 2008, so I was only 10 years old. And what it is that my dad passed away after he had a heart attack. And the reason why it was because he was smoking a lot. Like, he was smoking every single day and drinking wine and alcohol. Like, wine, beer. He would drink, like, a whole box of beer in one day. And trust me, I know because I saw it with my own two eyes. So, I had a rough period of time. I used to, like, you know, abuse people. Like, I used to hit people in the face. Push them. I kept on getting in trouble a lot. So, it was just kind of like, it was hard. And my teacher at that time, she didn't ask me why I was abusing people. Why was I, like, you know, this mad? Like, she didn't tell me what's going on with my life. She didn't tell me, like, how was your summer, none of that stuff. Because I had to go to a funeral. And at that time, that was, like, my first time going into a limousine. But this was, like, for my dad's funeral. It's not like, oh, there's a celebrity in that car, in that limousine. It's not, like, something like that. And at that time, I had short hair, like, it was, like, right here. And ever since then, I just, forbid myself having short hair, so that's why it looks long. Like this is how long it is. Like, this is how long my hair is. And if it's like wet, it goes all the way up to my stomach when I'm looking down. At that time, when I was abusing people, my teacher never asked me what's going on. She never, never spoke to me in private and all kind of stuff. It's just kind of like, it was a hard year. And a couple of months later, like in, October 15, 2008, that's when I first known, Justin Bieber through the internet. Like girls were like saying like, oh, there's this, look at Justin Bieber. Oh my God, he's so gorgeous. And trust me, I still act like that. It's just like, he's so freaking hot, especially when he takes off his shirt and show his abs to all his believers. So yeah, there's that feeling. Also because, like, you know, it was like, you know, the first time he actually was there for me when nobody else was, because I used to abuse people. So him, me listening to Justin Bieber's songs, like, one time all the way up to To You, which is his latest one, like this year, it was just kind of like he actually was there for me when nobody else was, not even Puta herself. And Puta means slut, bitch, whore, all in Portuguese. And I'm not gonna say who it is, because then you guys are gonna be like commenting like, oh, she's not a slut, she's perfect, and you're just like such a know-it-all, blah blah blah. So that's why I'm not gonna mention her name in this video. But like, if you're a hater of her and you know who she was dating in 2010 to 2013, to be honest, I had a feeling that she was gonna break Justin's heart. I had a feeling that she wasn't the right person to Justin. I'm not gonna control Justin's life. I'm not Patty, for instance. I'm not Justin's mom. I'm not Justin's parents, to be honest. Like, I'm not his parents. So yeah. So he was just kind of like, he was there for me when nobody else was. And his music helped me calm down throughout the 9 years. He helped me through of forgetting about like the feelings that of me losing my dad throughout those 9 years, because when I was only 10 years old, I was the baddest girl, and now I'm just like a girl. No, I'm sorry about that. I'm a woman, to be exact. I'm already an adult, so basically I'm a woman now. And throughout those 9 years, like, I've been listening, like, I've been replaying his music over and over again through CDs. And now, like, no speakers. And most of the songs that I have is in my phone, which is the Samsung Galaxy S3, which I'm recording right now. And he's just, like, he's just an amazing guy. And to be honest, if I could turn back time in 2014, I would. Like, the end of 2013 to the end of 2014, because Justin had a rough time in that year. It wasn't his year, and it wasn't his time to, like, now be happy. He was just like, no. It wasn't his ear. And it was all thanks to Puta for her selfish ways. And, like, after those 9 years of me knowing him, it was just been amazing. Since 2008, he's just been there. And ever since then, I will still love him. Like, by the time, October 15, 2017 comes, by this year, like, when October 15, 2017 comes, it will actually mark 1 year since I've been knowing Justin Bieber. Like, since I first known Justin Bieber. And basically today, Wednesday, June 21st, which is today, it actually marks 9 years since my dad passed away. And it was just hard, like, for him to leave my life like that. I was like his baby girl. I was his princess. And to me, I feel like I'm a daddy's girl than it is to me being around my mom. That's why I'm not used to being with my mom, with my sister. I'm used to being around my cousins, my uncles, my aunts, because, like, they don't, like, know, yell at me, they don't tell me what to do. And yeah, and also I also have my dad's brush right over there. I have my dad's cross that he had in his coffin. And I still have the stuffed animal. And I still sleep with it every single night. Like, I call him Justin Jr. If Leah's watching this, like, if my best friend Leah watching this, she knows who Justin Jr. is. Because, like, I post him on Instagram not as much, but every couple of times I'll put him on Instagram. Because he was kind of like the first doll that I ever kept before my dad passed away. And to be honest, I would give it to my daughter or son. I would give it to my daughter or son once I'm married and have kids. Hopefully it's Justin Bieber. I'm not saying, like, no, I'm actually gonna marry Justin Bieber, but, like, no. Hopefully someday I'll might meet Justin Bieber someday. Who knows? It's just kind of like, he's like, no, my lifesaver. And I might show Justin Jr. One second. So I got Justin Jr. and this is what he looks like. And to be honest, he's a cute animal. He's a Dalmatian. He has, like, two bones on his chest. What happened is that, like, he had to get stitched from my mom here and under his arm and on his butt too, like, right here, as you can see the little hole. I still need to redo that one. But, like, he's been with me since I was 4, and I still sleep with him every single night. I still sleep with him. even if people say you're too old to sleep with you're too old to sleep with stuffed animals. My sister is 24 years old, and she still sleeps with a stuffed animal. So it's just kind of like, I'm not the only one in my family that sleeps with a stuffed animal. And I don't know how to explain now. So I actually finished high school. I came back for one more year. After this year is done, I'm gonna be like now cleaning the house every single day to earn like $10 a week. Hopefully getting a job. Hopefully once I get more subscribers, or if people watch more of my videos and like them, and like they think like, oh, this girl is actually really nice, let me subscribe to her. That's up to you guys if you want to subscribe to my channel, to be honest. It is up to you. And like, if you guys enjoy this, if you could like, subscribe, share as many people as you can. And yeah, maybe I might become famous just by gaining a lot of subscribers. If you guys like the videos that I'm doing right now, you guys might like it. Maybe I'll like, no. See, like, for example, like, as you can see in the background, you can see, like, you know, Justin Bieber posters. And I have a necklace. I don't know if you can see. I think you could see. Yeah, you could see. I could see it right now. It even says Belieber on it. That kind of shows that I support Justin, even if what happened on the year 2014. I was still with him. I'm still with him, like, to his journey. And if people tell me that Justin Bieber does not know that you exist, Justin Bieber does not know you, or he doesn't love you, to be honest, he will love his fans no matter what. Even if you Beliebers haven't met him yet. He once said, and this is a quote that I saw on Google. He said, the Beliebers who haven't met me yet, they're the special ones. And to be honest, I haven't met Justin, like, in person, like, physically talking to him. I haven't met that kind of Justin yet. I've been to one concert. One concert. And that's because my cousin felt bad that I'd never been to a Justin Bieber concert. And now I've been one. Who knows? I might go to his Purpose tour. But I went to his Belief tour. And I had a blast going to that concert. And that's kind of like, you know, my life story. Because maybe someday in the future, like maybe 5 years later, I might retell it again and share more that I'm not haven't experienced yet. So I hope you really enjoyed the video. Please do subscribe if you liked the video. Hit that bell icon on the beside the subscribe button to get notifications to get notified when I'm uploading. I rarely upload because I've been busy a lot. Like right now, I finished my co-op placement. I finished it, and also because it's like the end of the year. So I really hope you guys enjoyed. Please do subscribe, as I said earlier. Share with as many people as you can. Also, please be sure to actually let your friends watch this video, and if they want to, okay. I don't control you guys. I don't. You guys, you live your own life. And so far. And just a heads up to you, I've been starting to sing like at the age of 3, so that was one thing I forgot in the story. That I started singing at the age of 3, and I still do when I'm listening to Justin Bieber. So I really hope you guys enjoyed the video. I really hope you guys enjoyed the video, as I said earlier, like a couple seconds ago. And I hope to see you guys next time. Bye!